not like that. It's the depends on the they will give that. See, when you are going to any cloud, I'm not talking about for AWS itself, Azure or AWS or GCC, they will define it for the shared responsibility. From the infrastructure side in the sense, like if you are following the ISO audit or ISO 2017 something for a security wise, they will ensure that it is in, they will give the 100% security for that hardware wise. When you are going the installation, install anything or deploying into the hardware, you need to be take care. That depends on you, but that's what you are. You guys are putting a more security on ordering. For example, if you are deploying any new server, you should do for us the OS hardening itself. Until unless you have to do for OS hardening, and then you need to put a firewall security. Even the cloud itself, they are giving a security group, but that is not enough. You need to put it like a Palo Alto or Check Point or Juniper. You have to deploy that also to make it as a perimeter firewall. And you need to be have a router firewall. Then there are a lot of things you need to be deployed. You know, especially only for Arab countries, still they are thinking for this way. But apart from, I will show you how many banking customers they are using in cloud. You know, World Bank, they are using AWS.
In AWS, do you have like on-premise and public cloud, private cloud concept?
Yeah, go ahead, go ahead.
Like,
Yeah.
the other con thing is like the main thing, the one of the advantage I can say on cloud is the cost. Like no need to go for to buy more hardware. It's hardware like virtual and cost of the hardware will go down. Like you don't need to have a big data center. So many things are, even the operation cost also will go down. So I understand those things are coming. So how about an AWS having a on-premise cloud or something like that? Do you have
See,
anything?
if that's what I want to explain for that also. See, when you are saying a cloud is it's kind of a their background. If you are going in Google itself, you can see AWS data center, you can see in a Facebook, or you can see in a YouTube itself. All are they are using a data center. It's a, they are giving a service as a cloud, but background there is a data center running.
That I can understand. Like that I can understand when they are in the cloud business, means they are managing so many enterprise data on their data center. Like each company enterprise has a different cloud.
Rajiv, your voice is not clear. Can you keep the mic close?
Yeah, I can understand. Like when you say like your AWS is running a data center, I can understand that it is handling so many enterprise data on their cloud. So they should have a big storage and they should have a big data center to handle all the corporate. I can understand that. But in my perception, what I am asking is geographical basis. Like here, there is a concern here in GCC. Like by policy, government policy, they are not allowing the enterprise to go to cloud.
Yes, I know that. The security they in not only for there, even some other what I can say, some other country itself, even China itself, if you are going a GCC, they won't allow you to do. That is depends on a government policy. See, but for the security wise, we need to define what exactly you need. You have to be the security specialist. You should have the security specialist to define what are the security features I can implement to my make it a thing. See, for example, you guys are saying about your on-premises. Will you think it about your on-premises is completely 100% secure? No one should not be trying to integrate something or try to injection something or. They usually do you think about that your on-premises no one try to hack it? Hello? Hello? Hello. Hello.
We can, yeah, we can hear you. Come, continue, continue.
We
No,
are able
I'm
to
just
hear you. Please
asking.
continue.
No, I'm just asking the question.
Yeah.
Even if it is an on-prem
Can
product.
we move on? I think it's a, I think can we move on to the next question? I think it's a, just a discussion. Maybe we can ask more questions related to the course itself. If someone is having about the course details, maybe that would be much even better.
Okay. Okay. So you guys have any questions, you can ask me, then we can go.
I think you should continue with the
Okay.
introduction. Question answer we can make in the last or any another session.
Okay, that's fine, that's fine, that's great. Okay, so here you can see for it is a utility computing. Utility is nothing but it's a tool. For example, like how can I say that you know that the magic lamp, we will say that na, whenever you are brushing something, you will get a new thing and then you can ask it. In that way, they are giving us a utility as a computing. Utility is a tool. Whatever the service you want, you can get it in the cloud. That's what they are trying to say in a utility computing. In utility computing, you can get it for an infrastructure. For example, it's an on-demand. Whatever the instance, see, when you are in on-premises data center, you, for example, today you want to buy it for a 2 GB and 4 GB RAM. Tomorrow you are not supposed to buy it for a 4 GB and 8 GB RAM. So that is not possible to buy it for immediately. That is the reason they are calling us an on-demand. Whenever you want, you can use it for whatever the server configuration you want. That you can get it from there. And pay as you go, that is a term called for whatever you want to use it, you can pay and you can use it. It's an upfront amount, that is for they called as a reserved instance. And uniform is in the sense, for example, when you are launching a, when you are spinning up a new instance or like VM, it will follow the workers background to tell your data center, this guy is asking this instance, I'm going to build it. It will follow the uniform and then it will give the availability itself. That is for available. You cannot see you in previously they faced like a lot of hardware issues also, not for only for AWS, even Azure, GCC also. Nowadays they resolved everything. Because they are building their own itself. And this is one more important. I already explained for the last class itself, I don't know how many people know that. One developer, that guy have a knowledge about infrastructure itself. The only one person can handle the complete company. Even I know a lot of my friends, they are running their own business itself. Those guys are a developer also. Because cloud, especially AWS, there are like hundreds of services available. All the services you can integrate with API. I know how many people know about API, application program interface. Either it is API, any base like REST API or API or AWS CLI itself, you can use it all the services. And you can see, especially AWS, they are providing most of the languages can integrate with AWS. Like Java, JavaScript, and Node.js, React.js, and whatever, even most of .NET Core, .NET Core 1.0, 2.0, even 3.0 itself, I don't know whether it came or not, but still, in Windows side, Linux side, whatever the OpenSUSE itself, all the languages will support the AWS. Most of the languages, I'm not saying for all, most of the languages will support for AWS. So, you don't need to go for AWS CLI only. You can use it any languages to integrate your complete infrastructure. That's what I'm trying to say. One developer can have complete infrastructure. So instead of that, you can get it for your compute. What are the services you can get it? This is for high level I mentioned. Compute is nothing but your VM. And scaling. You want to make it as a scaling that you can do it for, you can reset your instance. You can do for vertical scaling as well as horizontal scaling also, it is available. And security, as I said before, like security, it's a shared service model. In the hardware side, they will give the security and software, not only software side, OS, everything, you need to take care. You need to defend. That's for a shared responsibility. Whatever the infrastructure services are available in on-premises, that all services you can get it in the cloud. there is no services. If you guys are saying anything, services not in on-premises, not in cloud, I didn't see anywhere. No, I'm not talking about only for AWS. Even Azure, GCC also, they are providing all the services.
Okay.